To other football news, where after serving more than two decades at Orlando Pirates, veteran coach Augusto Palacios is set to leave his beloved Buccaneers. Palacios always worked closely with Pirates development structures. The 69-year-old Peruvian has thanked Pirates chairman Ivan Koza for allowing him to serve with the Soweto Giants for so long. He now joins us live via Zoom. A very good morning, Augusto. I mean, it's always difficult to say goodbye to one of the places that you spend most of your life in, and I'm just thinking, as an avid football fan, what are your noteworthy achievements or milestones with Orlando Pirates? When I think of one, I'd like to think maybe nothing surpasses the treble that you won with the team in 2012.
Yes, good morning to everyone. Compliment for the year. Yes, it was my honor and really a pleasure to work for the Institute of Orlando Pirates. Too many years, the emotional moment and difficult time also, but especially the good memory I had with the team. You know, appreciation, I say, for Dr. Ivan Koza for the opportunity to give to me to be in this Institute of Football, you know, in different roles and the development and the professional team, who are really the honor to work with. Too many people, especially the division who had a chairman in football youth development, who was great for me to work in more than two decades.
You arrived at Pirates just after the Bucks had won the CAF Champions League in 1996. Did that put any pressure in terms of what you need to contribute for the next years ahead?
I think the more important for the chairman when I meet him, it was the issue about the players who come in from the development, the culture of the team, the philosophy of the team, the history of the team. This was the more concern. We went to several tournaments international with under 12, with under 15, with under 17. And really, the achievement for him, it was great when later after, you know, too many players coming from the development. And especially for the earlier age, I think Pirates was the first club in the history in South Africa who had the development from earlier age. In the case of the Lebohang Mokwena, 10 years, Jose Makanya, Giler Emi, you know, Pomoso Manense, Leli Mayatele, Vilakasi, etc., etc. No, it's too many players. But also, we had a very sad moment, you know, when we lost life, you know, first, the one administration football who was Sodo Akosa, and also Leli Mañantela, Giler Emi, and Senso Moiba. Senso Moiba was coming when he had 14 years in Orlando Pirates.
Wow.
I mean, we achieved a lot in Orlando Pirates with the coaches also, ex-players who was in the team, and other coaches from the township. One of the key components of the chamber was exactly what he said, it's too many players in the township. Why are we not coming, the play coming from there? And this is what we achieved. The meaning is the mandate was always the youth policy in the team.
Coach, you have a heart for development, and you mentioned some Orlando Pirates legends in Gift Leremi, Lezi Manyatele, Benedict Vilakazi. And I know with development, specifically figures in football development, they have a special eye for talent. So what did you see in those young stars?
I think when I arrived in South Africa in 1984 in November, I will never know South African football only by name or some of the legends like Jomo Sono, Kaiser Motaua, Isolengo. But when I come into Wydad Black Aces, my first team who gave me the opportunity, and I went to the township to watching games and also in the school, it was fantastic talent. I would never believe to have this talent in South Africa. And then from there, obvious, it was not the proper structure development, and this is one of the key for me to observe the ability of the players, majority in a school, in the township. And more important is the players who come from disadvantaged family, and majority the players coming like this. And always my message to this player is, football is the talent who God gives to you, but you need to leave your family to another stage. Because we're coming from poor, but you need to take the player for another level. And one of the cases for me recently is now Lai Foster, who in 12 years I was developing him in my academy, And then in the age of 15 years, I take into Pirates, and now it's in Portugal. The same is Tabiso Monjane, who is now in the first team, and more players. I mean, for me, South Africa is one of the countries in Africa who had too many talents, but to develop in players, you need to be patient. You need to be the role model. You need to be the father. You need to be the friend. You need to understand what is the background of the player. It's not mean to take the player to the field and kick the soccer ball. No, you need to know the history of the player. Happy for me, the majority of the players in the development, I know from where coming. I know the family, and this is my job, because we need to respect everyone, and we need to know from where coming the players.
Coach Augusto, having said that, are you pleased with the state of South African football development and also African football development at large?
Yes, I always say very clear, I don't undermine any country in Africa, but South Africa with 55 million, it had too many talent, from Limpopo to Eastern Cape to Free State, etc., etc. In the Piga Township in Soweto, it's unbelievable the talent he had there. And I only say to local coaches, continue work while you're doing, you know, because this country had too much talent that we need to, what we say, to polish, because discovery is not the correct way, because the player coming with a national talent, but we need to look at his characteristic and correct mistake. And not only talk about football, talk about life, because it's very important, because the player coming from the school and then coming to the street, and all these things we need to monitor, very important.
Fantastic, Coach Augusto, and thank you for your time on the show today, and we wish you all best wishes for your future endeavours. That was veteran coach Augusto Palacios joining us to talk about the end of his journey with Orlando Pirates, which spans more than two decades. All right, so I'm going to